This is somewhere in Kingsbury Water Park by I think it's Pine Pool or something on the left hand side here, and this is just a little road inside winding off into the distance. We've got some nice silhouetted trees there against the light horizon, so let's have a look at the materials. It's all the usual gear, same palette I always have, 7 colours, Cotman watercolour tube squeezed out and laid to dry. We've got ultramarine, lemon yellow, Payne's grey, alizarin crimson, raw sienna, burnt umber, light red. We've got 3 brushes, large on rancinate, number 3 rigger, 3/4 inch flat. We've got a collapsible water jar here with a nice lip to take off a lot of the excess water off the hake. We've got a tissue in case you want to dab any colour off, and I've got 15x11 Fabriano watercolour paper. So looking at the picture again, the first thing I'm going to do when I put the sky and try and get the dark sky at the top and then sort of lighten it at the bottom, try and get some nice silhouettes there and then a winding path coming through to the foreground. Maybe there's no figures there, but might be a little figure walking off into the distance to give a focal point to it. We'll start off with the hake, clean water, and just give it a good soaking all over. Keeps it nice and lubricated, and it'll make sure the paper stretches evenly because you don't want any horrible crinkly bits. So that'll do for that. You can see I'm just picking up a bit of the paint off the board there. Don't worry about it if it happens to you. I'm just going to start just some. It's a bit of a dirty raw sienna that is. Just pick the colours are dirty, just go like that, clean them. Clean your brush, and then go straight back in, and then you've got a nice clean colour. Maybe just a bit of light red in there as well. That light red was a bit dirty as well, I think. Anyway, let's get some dark colours in. So I'm going burnt umber, I'm doing ultramarine, a bit of Payne's grey. Let's sort of brush down from the top, right from the very top, and just pull it right down. And I'm just going to keep going round the sides. I'm going to go in again. Bit of Payne's grey, ultramarine. I'm just going to brush that in again. Down the bottom. I'll stick a few little clouds in there. Actually, is there time to put another bit more? Let's just get a bit more. Get it really dark up there. Really dark. A few little clouds. That'll do. So next thing I'm going to do is pull this paper down. It's stretched a little bit. When it stretches, it pushes up a little bit, so you're sort of pushing the paper down onto the board all the time. So I'll just pull it flat as soon as I can. It might stretch a little bit more yet, but it's flat enough now to work with. So next thing I'm going to do is pull in those distant trees. So I haven't cleaned the brush, I'm just going to go into ultramarine, and I'll tell you what else I'll do, I'll switch this light on as well, see what I'm doing. I meant to do that at the start. So I'm going raw sienna, ultramarine, and trees are going to go about there, so I'm going to something like that. giving those furthest trees now on the right hand side. Actually, there's some big ones there. Just pop those in. Come down here, just change the colour a little bit. Just flicking from one to the next. Maybe even a few little trunks or what have you. Don't overdo it. And just to that, we've got a bit of grass. I'm going to clean the brush. I want to get some nice greeny bits. Back into the lemon yellow. I'm going to come out there. A bit too much water. Dry the brush a bit. Back into the colours. Bit of raw sienna. What I'll do next is put the path in. So I've cleaned the brush, take the excess off, and I'm going light red, burnt umber, too wet, clean it off. Light red, I keep saying burnt umber, ultramarine. Now then, it's just sort of like this, so get a pre-stroke in, and then just go something like that. Let the paint break. See, if it's too wet, it just goes like that. You want it a bit dry so it breaks. Which makes it a bit more interesting. See, look, breaks like that. Now, once it's on there, don't go over the same stroke because you'll ruin it. See, look, leave your strokes fresh. Just go once, just the once, and then leave it. It's so tempting to fiddle around with it and try and touch it up here and there, but 9 times out of 10, you just make it worse. So now the path's in now, I've got something to work to, so I'm just bring that over. Light red, I mean, lemon yellow, raw sienna, bring that down. Just trying to vary it now as I'm coming down. And again, just going it once, so I'm not going to go over there again now, I've done that bit. So now I'm going to try and keep varying the colour. Just starting from where I finished the last stroke. And just filling in those white bits. A few white bits look quite nice, but try not to overdo it. Maybe a bit of dirt down here, a bit of burnt umber. We've got a big tree, so I'm going to go burnt umber, ultramarine, chisel edge, like that, and then get your tree. Where are we going to start? About here, and then we're just going to go up, and then right off the top of the page, just pop the main bits in. And then you can always put the finer parts in with the rigger. Just let you put trees in really quick using this brush. Take it right off the edge of the page. Switch to the rigger. Plenty of water, back into the same two colours. Just put in some of the finer ends. That'll do it for that. I ain't going to mess about that anymore. Just want something down by the base. Just to ground it a bit, so a bit muddy, I think. So burnt umber, ultramarine, and I'm just going to pop in a few little dirty bits here and there.
just very light, hardly touching the paper. I'm just dabbing down like that. And then just a few little things there in the grass. That'll do. Paper's stretched again slightly, so I'm just going to pull it tight again. There's a bit of blue tack under there, so that's how that bit's staying down. So that's the left side. Now for the right, so first thing I'm going to do is a few more distant trees. So similar colours to what I've done here, namely ultramarine and burnt umber and raw sienna. And I'm just going to, just using the corner of the brush and then just going from one to the next, trying to vary it as I go along. That's going up to about there, something like that. And that comes down like that, and again, maybe a few little, twigs. So easy to overdo it once you get started. I'm going to switch to the, and it's still in the same two colours. I've switched to the rigger, plenty of water, and then we've got our little tree. Up there. Again, just very simply, it's just a few little strokes there with the rigger brush. And then if you want the little finer bits you get at the top, if you just scuff it up like that, actually, if you just do it like that, something like that, and then it's just give it a little dab like that. Okay, a bit too dry that was. Right, it's just experiment. It's just experiment with what you're doing. Just get in there and just put your fingers in it and just see what happens. I mean, what's... Something like that anyway. Give the idea of a tree. I'm going to clean the ape brush, clean the brush, take the excess off. It's getting a bit wet now down there. I'm just going to go lemon yellow, raw sienna, lemon yellow, a bit of ultramarine, just brushing that over, raw sienna. In there like that. So that's the sort of main background bit in there. So I'll just give that a quick dry. Back to the rigger, same two colours I used for those distant trees. And you're sticking a very very simple little figure. Don't do them too big, just thank you. the impression of something walking along there. So three little birds in the sky. And I think I'll call that one finished. Pop your signature down in the corner. You're a quick guy, didn't you? Let's have a closer look at it.
So here's our painting. Let's have a quick look at the photograph. So I've really tried to emphasise the sort of light sky down at the horizon level. So just using a bit of light red just to give it that sort of orangey glowy colour, and then contrasted that with the sort of dark ultramarine Payne's grey at the top. A few clouds here and there, put in with the tissues. And then coming right down to the horizon where we've got nice light orange glow of the sort of evening sunset. We've got a nice windy path there. Always put them in windy rather than just straight. They just look a lot more interesting. And then just a little figure somewhere walking off into the distance generally helps. Again, the path just put in with just one sweep. Of the brush, and then just a little figure. And keep varying your greens as you come down. It makes it a lot more interesting. Don't just put them in one monotonous tone. And a few light and dark colours. If you change the tone, and you sort of get these sort of automatic shadows appear. Well, thanks for watching. Keep practicing. Any questions, please ask, and I'll see you again soon.